closure is what both parties are aiming for, but as of Tuesday, when the TUF and the government negotiating team return to the negotiating table, closure remains elusive. As the end of the 2010-2013 triennium draws to an end, public servants are becoming increasingly tense about an agreement being reached between the government negotiating team and public sector unions on the issue of salaries. TUF President Julian Monroe says the union's membership is indeed anxious for a settlement. He says the TUF is willing to negotiate its stated 15% request.
We are hoping that that we will get an opportunity to actually negotiate, and our hope is that we can bring conclusion to these negotiations. Our members have been waiting for a very long time. They're getting nervous, and they want a settlement to this. Our hope is that the government negotiating team this morning will make a very serious offer to us, one that we can discuss. Our position has always been that while we had asked for 16% and move it to 15%, that was not a final position for us.
Head of the government negotiating team, Vern Gill, says the last few meetings with individual unions have progressed well, and he's hoping the same will apply with the salary negotiations.
We've been meeting with all the unions individually to deal with conditions of work and allowances. Today we're going to meet with the whole TUF grouping to revisit the issue of the salaries. So we hope today we can get to some point of resolution.
But Monroe says a 0% increase is not in the cards for public servants. He says the TUF will not entertain the offer made previously by the government.
You see, we're looking at a salary increase. It is impossible, well, it's just not possible to increase anything by zero. You know, zero means nothing. That's what it means. And so we're not interested in nothing. We're interested in something. What that something will be will depend on the negotiation, but it cannot be nothing.
The two parties will go back to the negotiating table on Thursday. Lovely St. Amy Joseph, HDS News Force.